Hello, Zensei here. Today, we're going to be launching an entire space station in a single launch and assembling it in orbit, but not in the way you might expect. We're going to be using a robotic arm to grab pieces of the space station, move them around, and dock them in various locations. I've never seen anyone do this before, so I thought it would be really interesting to try. So without further ado, let's get into it. I tried to use a pretty standard gravity turn for this launch, although I do think it could have been more efficient. This rocket was really hard to control. It was pretty heavy, and the robotic arm was wobbling all over the place. In fact, there were quite a few times when it clipped out of the fairing and was partially visible. You'll notice that before I stage, I try to point my rocket prograde. The reason for this is because I want to make sure that the empty boosters don't crash into my rocket once I stage them. I don't know about you, but this has happened far too many times than I care to count, and I really didn't want that to ruin this mission. Throughout the launch phase of this mission, you'll notice that I have Kerbal Engineer Redux open on the left-hand side of my screen. I really like this mod, I find it incredibly useful, and while I was launching this space station, there were a couple of things that I was paying attention to. One of those things was the time to apoapsis. Now, I wanted to make sure that my time to apoapsis was constantly going up. I'm no rocket scientist, but I do know this. If the time to apoapsis is going down, that means my rocket is moving closer to the highest point in its flight. Now, if that happens when I'm not ready to do my orbital burn, that means I'm going to start falling back down towards the planet's surface, and that is something I wanted to avoid with this mission. Another thing I was paying attention to was my speed. I wanted to make sure that I would reach escape velocity and actually get this station into orbit around Kerbin. Once I'm at about 50,000 kilometers, I'm going to start thinking about my maneuver node. Now, you'll see me add a maneuver node here, but I'm going to end up tweaking it and moving it around a little bit later on. The reason I made one now is because I want to make sure that I have enough time to my apoapsis in order for me to point my rocket in the right direction, fire my thrusters, and complete the burn that I need to make in order to get me into orbit. You'll notice that the time before I need to start making my burn is well below my time to apoapsis, so I'll have plenty of time to adjust my maneuver node, get my rocket pointed in the right direction, and fire my thrusters. Or at least, that's what I thought. As it turned out, because this rocket was so massive, the SAS had a very hard time getting it to rotate and point towards a maneuver. What I actually had to do was fire the rocket's thrusters ever so slightly, just to take advantage of the gimbal in the engines to help point my nose towards that maneuver node. But once all is said and done and I get into orbit, I deploy my fairing, and this is it. This is the space station that I'm going to assemble in orbit using that robotic arm that's on top. You'll notice that there is quite a bit of wobbling going on here. I think the reason for this is because I used a rotor as the core of the space station. As I learned, rotors don't have a whole lot of structural support, and it kind of fought against the SAS when it was turned on. The reason I used a rotor is because I wanted to be able to dock a module to the underside of the station and have it rotate freely. If I were to do this again, though, I would probably use a more sturdy part like the multi-point connector for that extra rigidity. This wobbling made me very nervous because I did not want the deep space kraken to grab a hold of my vessel and cause some unanticipated explosions. So something you'll notice I used a lot is time warp. It's actually going to come into play right now. There is a stack separator stuck on the space station. Try saying that 5 times fast. So I enter time warp, let that drift away, and now my space station is completely separated from all the other stages. Throughout this flight, time warp was my friend. In Kerbal Space Program, if you go into time warp, the game stops applying basic physics to your vessels. You'll notice that whenever my rocket starts to wobble a little too much, I go quickly into 2x time warp and then back to normal, and I just fluctuate between the two until my wobble is entirely canceled out. This trick has saved me so many times, not just in this flight, but in others as well. And if you didn't already know about that, I highly recommend using it because it will get you out of so many difficult situations. You'll notice that when I grab the electrical module here, the arm actually clips through the station. That's because thankfully I had same ship interaction disabled. Otherwise, that could have been disastrous to this mission. There's a total of 6 modules on this station. There's the core, a science bay, a habitation bay, fuel and ore refining and storage, electricity production and storage, which is being moved right now, and of course, the robotic arm itself. When I designed this station, I wanted to keep the electrical module and the fuel module separate from the habitation bay and science bay, or really anywhere where Kerbals would be moving around inside the station. I like to imagine the Kerbals moving around inside, and it really doesn't make sense to me to have them move through a large fuel tank in order to get from one part of the space station to another. The actual docking of the modules was kind of nerve-wracking because I had to let go of it with the Advanced Grappling Unit Junior before docking. So that meant that I had to make sure the module was close enough to the docking port so that the magnetic force of the docking ports was strong enough to pull them close together. If it wasn't, then the module would just float out into space and be lost, and that would be mission over right there. The last module that we're going to be moving is this fuel and ore refining and storage module. That fuel storage has a lot of mass, and in microgravity, that mass means that it's a lot more difficult to move that module around. Because every action has an equal and opposite reaction, the space station itself would move around the fuel tank rather than moving the fuel tank around the space station. But in the end, I was able to dock it and get it into the right spot. All that's left to do now is open up the solar panels, make sure we're getting power, and do some science. The core of the science module is the mobile processing lab. In my opinion, this is one of the most useful parts you can have on a space station or surface base. Mid-game, you can use it to farm science and unlock the entire tech tree. Late game, once you've unlocked the tech tree, you can set up the research rights sellout strategy in the administration facility to take 100% of your science and turn it into funds. This works out to almost 39,000 funds for every 750 science you transmit. It's not a huge amount, but when you're strapped for cash, every little bit helps. And with that, the space station is done. It's ready to receive astronauts, refuel vessels, and conduct scientific experiments in orbit. I had a really fun time designing, launching, and assembling this station. It was a little bit frustrating at times. I had to reload a few quick saves, but overall, I think it turned out really well. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. If you have ideas or suggestions for videos you'd like to see in the future, let me know in the comment section. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. It would really help me out. I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it, and until next time, take care.